Hey y'all, it's Mitch with Guitar Town Guns here. I'm out here in my garage. Excuse the mess, but I don't work out here anymore. So I've been out here making these target stands, and I think they're pretty cool. I want to show you basically how I got them made, and if you might like to build some. It's a pretty cool idea, or at least I think so. What I've done is I've taken a bunch of plywood and I've cut it up. The long pieces are 6 feet long, 2¼ inches wide, and the cross pieces are 3 inches wide. I have pocket screwed one about 35 inches down and one about 6 inches up from the bottom. And then I got those together. This one here is 24 inches and goes across the back. And then I've taken a router with a 1/4 inch slot cutting bit, and I have cut a 1/4 inch slot all the way down here and all the way down here. Now what we're going to do is, since we have to rod it first before we put the other piece in, we've got another 24 inch piece. I've pre-drilled some holes, and what we will do is screw these into here. Great. Target is in here. I don't know if you can see that real well, but that's my target. Now what I've also have done is I've made a stand for a base, have you, that is basically a plywood box. This one is, you know, 5.5 inches tall, and I've got these two pieces here and a piece in here, and this is about 2 3/8, that's about 2 3/8, and if you set it on the floor, you can set this in there, as opposed to permanently attaching this and, you know, having to cart it around. Where I shoot out in the wilderness there, my buddy's farm, it's probably a good quarter of a mile up to the tobacco barn where we shoot. So these make it really light and really convenient, because I can carry 5 or 6 of these at a time. So I will move this. Let me move the camera. I need a camera person. Slide it into where the slots are, and there you go. Target. Pretty nifty, and like I said, when it comes time to dig it, you've got an inch or so here, and you just pull this target out, you know, and carry it like this, take it off the base or whatever, and that's it. You know, I've used these before, and it works really cool. If by chance you don't have, you know, like the carpentry skills that I have, not that mine are great by any means, I could probably do another video going through each step of the process on how to make these things, but they're pretty simple. But if you need more detail, just leave a comment or, you know, PM me, and I'll make another video, which will probably be about 20 minutes long. But this works pretty good. And as you can see, let me get behind the camera here. You can see the base, where it sits up into the base. And then you see your target. And also, I mentioned Target Barn earlier. They have these little target paster sticker thingies. So you can shoot 10, 12 rounds in it and put the little stickers over your bullet holes and basically go back and start shooting again. But that's an IDPA target on a stand that's fairly lightweight, and it's pretty cheap to make, I guess. Chances are you're gonna shoot this up pretty bad. That's why I use plywood as opposed to real wood. And that's it. So thanks for watching, and stay tuned.